And that brings a tear to your eye socket.
Mm-hmm. In the midst of all the killing and skin eating, somehow we forgot the love.
Ain't that always the way you get nuts with the skin eating? You know, I don't see any reason why freaks and norms can't get along.
Yes,
Yeah. We can all work together to build a utopian society free of violence, hate, and prejudice.
That sounds beautiful, Ned. And let me just say, my family and I share your vision for a better now!
And so it's time for the good, the bad, and the ugly. Because at the end of the day, a lot of people, they turn on each other. We don't want to have nothing to do with mutants. And everybody is mutants to everybody. That's the problem. Because we see ourselves as different somehow. When actually, if you look at our commonalities, they far outweigh any differences. So it's time to come and sail away into the truth about the way racism has always been seen. So only now can we reverse our curse. And so let the music play on. And know, therefore, as I cross my legs, sending you this message from Canada about the oneness of man and the kingdom age to come, Our Majesty of Majesties declares in Jeremiah 32:27, saying, I am the Lord God of all mankind, and that has always included all of the good, the bad, and the ugly, who commit not love's unforgivable sin. Since Jesus Christ Almighty, the living word of God in Matthew, says that all of our sin, Matthew 12, shall be forgotten and forgiven, exactly as Jeremiah 31 lays out, 33 to 36 verses. So for our carpenter of the ages is now sending forth his word of love, since his word was only closed until the time of the end. And so let's get ready, because it's glorious, and his glory shall cover the earth as waters covering the sea. And his word was only closed until the time of the shattering of racism could happen, as Daniel 12:7 says, the shattering of the power of the holy people, the shattering of our illusions and delusions that somehow we're different from one another. For it is therein written that our Lord of Kings and King of Lords evermore is saying that these are the days of the latter day Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord's kingdom age new covenant for all those who are willing to hear he who comes to feed the master's household, because the master is away. Meat, it's time for meat, as he foretold in the riddle of Matthew 24. And so the Lord says in the word of God in Matthew 12, I say unto you all manner of sin and blasphemy shall be forgiven absolutely all people who keep their love alive as they were when they were little children. And even though these are days of COVID's great trial of all flesh, exactly as foretold in Revelation 3, to bring his word of patience, to keep us from the hour of the temptation not to change, we must beat our swords into the sickle in these days of the revelation of the good, the bad, and the ugly. And even though these are days of Daniel 12's prediction correctly of the great Russian bear, Daniel 7:5 actually, chewing on the ribs of the king of the south, Ukraine, which the three ribs caught in between its fangs clearly are Crimea, Donetsk, and Luhansk. Even so, does the Lord's very own voice lovingly come forth to prepare his own way, exactly as Malachi 3:1 foretold, for he says to all people, keeping their love alive, not committing the unforgivable sin, he says, I will be your God, you will be my people. He says, I will forgive your iniquity, I will never remember it. I'll write my law and my love on your hearts, and beyond that, no one will ever even need to be taught of me, says the Lord God Almighty, for all people of love as a child shall know me. For those who love are born again and know me, for I am love, 1 John 4:7. So it's time to welcome with open arms the Lord, his love, his greatest ballad of the good, the bad, and the ugly. So let the oneness of all people together now be embraced and celebrated. For the bad are always good sometimes, and the good are always bad sometimes, since every one of us is constantly changing. So now behold the ugliest truth of truth, that ugly are the spiritually, those who are beautiful on the outside, many times they're ugly on the inside, and vice versa. And once all healing vanishes and is vanquished, our hurts, the ugliest of all are the most beautiful on the inside. Once they can release their most painful memories of spiritually racist condemnation over their outward appearance, they have become like wilted flowers, but flowers none the same. And they have been humbled by multitudes, making the ugliest frowns instead of smiles at them. No kindness in the land. And so it's time, love from love, hope from hope, peace from peace, and faith from faith. And may you also receive overflowing mercy from our everlasting peace bringer. For his mercy shall surely endure forever. For his peacefulness far transcends our own. And may you all receive peace from peace and love from love, who is our living love of the ages. So welcome to his kingdom age's greatest ode, to the nice and to the incorrigibles, and to all those letting their love wax cold, and to the ugly people of incredible inner beauty that even far outshines the outer beauty of all the good-looking Angelina Jolies and Brad Pitts out there, all put together, with the possible exception of Atlantis Morissette, naturally, because she just couldn't take it anymore. That's why she ended up eating that jagged little pill. And I can't blame her. I've done a little bit like that in my time as well. But one thing is for sure, it's time to turn the page, and it's time to listen. To listen to the loud roar of the roaring lion of Zion, who's purring for us to start being kind by the letter of his word in motion. Hear the great whistle sound. Hear the great alarm of the end times. Hear the absolute vanity of vanities, saith the preacher, for all not putting their love in action. For we can know all the mysteries of the universe, but we've got to take a jagged little pill, a pill of that will be poison to us, so that we lean not to our understandings, but unto our Lord of loves. Because all things work together for good for those called according to his loving purposes, which is absolutely every one of us. So it's time to step up. It's time to saddle up. It's time to go where only the brave will go. Even though they might be cowardly, yet they go into hell for a heavenly cause. So it's time for love's greatest tribute to the easy, to the hard, and to the bubbly, bumpy uglies of the world, all the people thereof. So let the truth ring out that when such little itty bitty drugs of our twisted perceptions, when that goes down, the temperature of our imagination goes way, way up, so that our passions may arise. So let all people now learn from our Lord of Hope's very best song of his love, because all are great, all that are terrible, and all that contort, and all that twist their outward beauty all to hell, just because they somehow forgot their most bitter ways that their smiles are unable to reverse the curse of their frowns. So they keep walking forth as a crazy person, but he is the Lord God of all of them committing not on the blasphemy of the Holy Spirit. All blasphemies, will be forgiven, all of us, because all of us have blasphemed that which is good. So welcome unto the Ancient of Days' greatest psalm about his overflowing love for all people who won't commit the unforgivable sin of blasphemy of love's holiest Holy Spirit by their hateful souls letting go of love, letting that light to go right out, because that is what used to be God living within them. For all those who love are born of him. And it's time to hear the music play. For he alone is our everlasting love and our endless hope. These are the days of Elijah, days for the good and the bad and the ugly, all to begin shining under the Lord's most radiant, fervent love, which he's now wanting to pour out like a love song over absolutely all flesh, exactly as the prophet Joel foretold. For he has given forth his kingdom age new covenant of Jeremiah 31, 33 to 35, unto absolutely all flesh. So let all those against racism embrace this most beautiful song about a whole lot of ugly people within, and let the transformation of love's brightest light begin sizzling away within these four total days of love's hottest refiner's fire to become ablaze all over all the circles of earth. So let the rich say they are poor, and let the ugly say they are really beautiful within, and let the wise admit that they have often been much dumber than some other stupids who already know that they've already been fools because they've been far too deathly afraid of changing absolutely anything about the comfortability of their lives because they're in a comfort zone of existence. They will never thrive. They will never be alive. So it's time to come alive, because otherwise good senses illogically just keep refusing to abandon our same old. It's time for a change. It's time to repent. It's time to find a new spouse. It's time to go back with the old one. It's time to open up closed hearts and closed minds. Even the so-called believers in love cannot be loving at all, while some people other out there who seem loveless are actually extremely loving under the right circumstances. Remember the movie Birdman of Alcatraz? He loved that bird. So let the fires of man's oneness flare over the truest truth, that even so-called religious people are not religious whatsoever within the forgiven private moments of all of their accepted sins that they don't want no one to know about, because there is no good man. No, has there never been one. And know that even people who are not religious, they are still religious about much in their daily lives. Their God might be their sexuality, or their money, or their entertainment, or whatever drug they're on, but they are religious about it. And that's why there are thousands, literally, of religions out there, and most of them are refusing to see the clearest truth of love, hope, and peace, and faith's most blessed hope of change. For the Lord God says unto all people, he says, we must beat our sword of love into the sickle thereof. For he is the sower of the seed of love who has overtaken his reaper. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And so know that there has never been any gross darkness darker than the ignorance of love alone. So let all Einstein wannabes out there of love, let them start shining with the truest end time truth that absolutely all judgmental and all condemning and all unloving religion, unforgiving, is completely a dead letter, exactly as the Apostle Paul foretold in Hebrews 8 that would happen in the latter days. That is an end time prophecy manifested now. And so it's time to see that devotion unto all unloving religions can now begin blowing away as smoke, exactly as Hebrews 8 foretold. And as our Lion of Zion allows his greatest hymn of love to flow like the most beautiful melody of his adoration over all of the so-called the good, the bad, and the ugly. Let the wise desiring to shine as the sun, exactly as Daniel 12 predicted for these latter days, let them now rejoice over our forthcoming Emmanuel, our Lord God, who will be with us again real soon. And so it's time to celebrate our diversity, because our diversity can bring us together. For the truest truth is, it's time for the good, the bad, and the ugly to sandwich a bunch of beauty. Because it doesn't matter who's on top, who's on the bottom, because we're all spinning round and round. None of us really know which way is up, unless you look unto our love, and where he is, that is always up in the right heavenly direction. So it's time to get excited. It's time to become fervent, because our Lord will save us. The most exciting verse in the whole Word of God is Jeremiah 30:24. For it is written, and it says, and this shall be considered in the latter days. We should consider that the Lord is saying, just like Jonah did not have Nineveh destroyed, as he said before, God relented. That is the exciting thing, that God is willing to relent, that he says, I shall return my most fierce, terrifying anger, if only my loving people will give me that, and be more loving, and be kind unto others. For if they cannot be kind unto others, they can not see, or they can see, they cannot love a God who they cannot see. So it's time to rejoice over our forthcoming Emmanuel, our Lord God, our God with us, who shall again be soon. So blessed are all those embracing the truest truth of the good, the bad, and the ugly, the truest truth of Romans 3:10. For it is absolutely rightly said that there is no good person ever in that has walked this world. No, not even one. And I'm talking about all the natural men. So here we are. Here we are, finally, at the end of the day. And that's why Christ said, at the end of the day, we will all get the same pay. That's the kingdom of God. So here we are, all the bad, all the good. And all the bad are trying to be good sometime, and all the good are bad sometimes. So please like and share this video, because it's the word of John Lennon's Imagine mentally coming forth as a razor, a sharper than a two-edged sword of peace, so that we can all finally learn to get along together as we throw away our most tainted hypocrisy by our most perfect love, casting out our fear, even the fear of our differences, when there's never been really any differences at all. So please endorse our Lord's of Love's greatest psalm of his unchanging love for all the good, all the bad, and all the ugly, for all of his own, who commits not blasphemy of the Holy Spirit, in spite of many of them mostly being just the confused and the confusing, and those who aren't even sure of which way they should go. And behold our majesty of majesties, as he arises exactly as Isaiah 60 has foretold. For he arises as our son of love for the good, for the bad, and for the ugly, who will now begin destroying all of our gross darkness, so that our kindness can begin flowing again. And these are the days of Shiloh, the days of Daniel 12:13. That was to come in the latter days. So let the great jubilee of jubilees finally begin for love's unending celebration. For these are the foretold days of our Lord of Love's foretold end time mercy upon me, upon my wife Linda, upon my family, Clay and Aaron, Esther, Jewel, and Jake, Matthew. And so it doesn't matter. Think on things that are good and lovely, of good report, and do not worry that these are the days of the great bear of Daniel 7:5 arising. And it doesn't matter if he does hear the voice telling him, "Now you may go eat all the meat that you would like, for our Lord God of mercy is going to make a way where there has seemed to be none other." That is why he said that unless these days were cut short by his word in motion, that no flesh could be saved. Matthew 24. So this is a blessed hour that has been foretold by Daniel the prophet, Hildegard of Bingen, Gregory Rasputin of Russia, and it is written that our world's newest Vlad the Impaler, Mr. Putin himself, shall be assassinated if he relents not. Nor can it be denied that the prophet Kim Clement outright said in the spirit, "Thus saith the Lord God in his name, that he shall, Putin shall fall upon Russian swords." But let none celebrate his early demise. Pray for the man's heart to change. Our future is not written. Tomorrow has not yet come. Yesterday is gone. Only now is important. So let the wise see that these are the glorious days of Daniel, in which the Lord's glory shall start covering the earth like a flock of flamingos all over African ponds, like red waters all over the world that are beginning. For these are the days of love's greatest harvest of love. For the fields are white with snow during these days of love's hottest refiner's fire. And so let the band play on and know that the good, the bad, and the ugly are all better damn well be on the same team, because we're all gonna sink or swim together. And so it's time that we understand that it doesn't matter if we're different from one another. That kingdom age covenant promise written for all of mankind is without exception for all not letting their love go out. So in closing, know that these are indeed, therefore, the days of the great refiner's fire of love. And that great refiner's fire is burning, and it's beginning to make the world feel like a burning oven that will make people either very bitter or much better. And so it depends on what delusions or illusions we have within haunting our souls, whether we see things half full or half empty. And so it's time that all fools need to change into smart ones by choice, and smart ones don't need to change into foolish ones, because the delusions or the illusions of their mind or their darkest part of their heart, it's like a pill that makes their love either larger or one that will make their hearts be much smaller. Just like the Grinch who stole Christmas, who was so damn mean he didn't even have to think twice about stealing Christmas. And the narrow-minded kind of pills that many mothers have fed us just make people lazy and not want to do anything at all. It's just like that song, Go Ask Alice, when she's 10 feet tall. And if you feel, and if you behold a heat wave and see a heat wave, don't weigh back. It's time to get on. Let a little sweat run down your brow to let you know you're alive and you can feel the heat, feel the burn. For if the good, the bad, and the ugly ever get together with the terrible, the awesome, and the deformed, the bad karma, and all those shall reap what they have sown evermore, then they would just keep spinning their wheels as they go chasing rabbits like Alice in Wonderland did. So let the wise either awake right now out of our delusionary thinkings. If you have a spouse that loves you, love him back, love her back, forgive them unconditionally. And so, otherwise, now or forever, it'll come to pass that all foolishly not hearing this word will come to see how they're going to fall for some hookah smoking caterpillars that just want to keep giving them insanity's craziest call, just like Alice. So let the small become large, and let the large never become small. Let your hard heart grow manifold. So don't ask what you wish for, or as Alice was, so you too could become so very small. So let the good, the bad, and the ugly all now transform by love. For at the end of the day, upon this mountain, it is written in Isaiah 25 that all people of the earth, if they believe the word of love herein, will have all of their guilt and all of their shame burnt right out of them by the fire that is so hot that it purifies golden hearts into platinum and silver into the purest 24 karat. So in this hour, it's time that people need to stop acting unkind, just like they ate some kind of mushroom that's causing their love to move so super slow. They might as well call them turtle love. Turtle love. And remember that hamster love? Butterfly kisses, maybe? But one thing's for sure, let all wanting huge hearts to grow, let them all finally now come to see that when logic and proportion have fallen all sloppy dead, and when the white knight is talking backwards and the red queen's off with her head, remember what the Dormouse in Alice in Wonderland always said, as you run like hell, like a glutton, to feed your empty heads, if you won't give this a thumbs up. Amen.